Hello and welcome to One North Maine, BCA's magazine show where we profile people, places, and events that make this city our city great. I am on top of the Brockton Community Access roof to look at all the beauty surrounding us in the downtown area. There are some great buildings in this city and there's a lot of activity, but I'm not here to talk about that. I'm here to talk about five fantastic events that we recently covered for One North Maine. The 13th annual ArtSmart competition was held at the Brockton Public Library. A public meeting was held for designs on the Walker Playground at Raymond School. The Brockton High School Chorus yet again dominated for their annual choral concert. People from NASA visited our fair city to celebrate some great women. So sit back, relax, and see what your community, the City of Champions, has to offer. Over my right shoulder is the Times Building, erected in 1897. It really is a work of art. I'll also tell you about works of art. The ArtSmart contest, its 13th annual, was held at the Brockton Public Library, the main branch in downtown Brockton. Students from Brockton Public Schools competed, and their works were simply fabulous. Let's take a look.
I want to welcome you all and thank you all for coming. To support your student artists is really important to us in this city and in the high school, and we really appreciate it. The other people we'd like to thank is Paul Engel. He's the director, the new director of the library. And he's, in the little conversation I've had with him tonight, I can tell, very supportive of the arts. So welcome. We're happy to have you here. The other person we want to thank is Lucia Shannon. She just recently retired from the library, and she started this. This is her baby. And it's really nice that it's continuing on. And is it 13 years now,
something like
Lucia?
13.
Yes. Yeah. So it's just a wonderful event, and it allows our high school kids to show the work, the quality work that they're doing with the community, and the thought behind the work. So if you have time tonight, if you talk to some of the artists about what, you know, what they were trying to communicate with their artwork, I think you'll find it interesting.
I just want to say that I've been here for about 3 months now, and the art that is been presented in this library is just nothing short of phenomenal. And when I came up here after this, just shortly after this exhibit had been put up, I was awestruck when I walked in. The art that I see in here is simply great. And I think everybody in this room, there's 29 works in here, and all of them, I congratulate all of the artists in here for their work. I come from an artistic background. I'm a musician and a composer, so I get it. And this is the 13th anniversary of this. I have it in the, I did some research. and I'm hoping to continue this for generations to come. And I think this is something that I was speaking to Sarah and to Lucia about. I think this is a program that we can present to other libraries to do as well. I think Brockton has really hit on something here. And I'm really moved by this. Javon Dixon has received an honorable mention for Blue Tranquil. Is Javon here? Tanya Alves, her work is the Fine Arts Finest Fish, which I believe is the one right behind me. So second prize goes to Elise and Angela Pyres. Elise Angela Pyres, and her work is the African Princess, which is right here. Is Elise in the room? For first place,
Nessie DeBosom.
She won for Expressive Self-Portrait.
That's right here.
Which is right here. And I'll have to say, when I walked in, that one caught my eye immediately. To the rest of you who displayed your work again, fabulous. I'm really moved and touched by your abilities, and I wish you all the best in your endeavors as you travel. I know some of you are going to art school, and I've been there. I went to music school, so enjoy the ride. Enjoy the ride while you do it. Thank you very much for coming tonight.
There are so many great playgrounds in this city, I can't keep track. One in particular caught the public's attention. It was the Walker Playground at Raymond School, and the public was invited to redesign that beautiful piece of land. It was exciting. Let's check it out.
Thank you guys for coming out. We really appreciate that. Tonight, what we plan on doing is a group of table exercises to come up with a design that the community wants for this particular playground. We've been working at this for a while. We think we've got a good strategy for how to approach this. This is the playground. You can see here in the corner, this is the Raymond School where we are now. And as you move towards the north and east, this is our target property that we've been working with. So we have these 1 inch equals 11, so it's to scale of the Walker Playground. And what we plan on doing is working with these templates that our park designer has provided with us. So we have all sorts of different templates of different play fields. And we're concentrating on the play fields because that's the most active part of the park. There's going to be areas for walking paths, and there can be areas for gardens and more trees and all sorts of things like that. That's going to come part of the after process of figuring out where the play fields and activity zones are going to be.
Hi, I'm Shirley Azak. I'm the Ward 7 City Councilor, and tonight we're here at the Oscar Raymond Elementary School. We're here with a residents from the city. Many of them are abutters to the Walker's Playground. Walker's Playground is right here behind the school. It's at the end of May Avenue off of North Main Street. A few months back, we received a grant to redo and fix up our park. The planning department has worked hard on this. They have they have split everybody up into groups. They've given them little pieces of fun things that can be in the park, different games, fields that they can place. And each group is going to be in charge of creating their own plan for what they would like to see in the park.
Well, hi, my name is Rob May. I'm Director of Planning and Economic Development for the City of Brockton. And we're here at the Raymond School for a community meeting to talk about the design for a new Gilbert Walker Playground. This administration under Mayor Carpenter has been working with our planning department and our Parks and Recreation Department to apply for state funding to rehabilitate several parks in our community. And we've worked on the south side most recently with Edgar Playground and Keith Park, and now we have a chance to do a park up here in the Montello neighborhood. And each group has a map or aerial photograph of the park and several puzzle pieces, which are basically the shapes of the various playgrounds and recreational fields that could possibly go into the park. We've given people more than what can actually fit on the park, so it's really an exercise in what do people want, what do the neighbors want, how does it fit into the park, how does it work best in the, to serve the needs of the community and the needs of the neighborhood.
Well, my name is Moses Rodriguez, and I'm one of the at-large city councils here in Brockton. As you can see, we've got quite a few people behind me here on this community meeting to discuss the future of Waco Playground. It's an important playground here in the city. And by bringing people together to discuss what they want in their neighborhoods, to me, is the form how government should work. It should not really be up to us sitting or living in different places to decide what's good for the neighborhood. It should be the neighbors deciding what's best for them. So I want to thank Shirley Azak, the ward council from Ward 7 here in this area, and some of the other officials that are here from City Hall and from the Parks Department, individuals who are taking seriously the concerns of the neighborhoods, thinking that it's important for us to keep in mind that we're only employees of the taxpayers and the ratepayers in this community, and it's up to us to do what the taxpayers want in this community. And we appreciate the fact that they came out, and we have to respect what the taxpayers want. And we as city government, we're going to do what's best for them, according to them, and we'll continue to listen and fulfill the wishes of the folks in our community.
We're at the Brockton High School Gymnasium for the 50th annual Health and Wellness Fair. Every student at the high school gets to participate today. There are some great vendors and some fun activities. Let's get to the action.
My name's Nick Lee. I'm director of Phys Ed here in Brockton, and today is the annual wellness fair at Brockton High. We have various agencies come from the outside, the community, Bridgewater State, a lot of partners that have joined us in the past to give nutrition awareness, drug and alcohol awareness, mental health awareness. We have LGBT community members here, a large variety of giveaways for the students. They each have a rubric to go by to give us feedback on each station of the fair. But we look forward to having another great year and continue this moving forward.
I'm Andrea Hoagland. I'm a peer mediator. I've been a peer mediator for about a year now. The peer mediators today are spreading awareness of what peer mediation is, because there's a lot of students at school who don't even know that we exist. And we're here to solve problems for the students and for administration. We're here as a helpful resource for the students.
Man, there is so much happening at this Health and Wellness Fair today. I am actually outside the gymnasium, and I'm at the signature healthcare table where they check cholesterol and run a test. And I'm here with Mary from the hospital. Mary, tell us a little bit about the test.
Well, the test is just a general cholesterol screening. It doesn't tell you you're good or you're bad. And it only ranges from 150 to 300, so if anything's high or low, we would tell you to follow up with your doctor on that. Obviously, when you get your cholesterol screenings or anything like that, you want to do fasting, but if you've already eaten, it might be a little off, but that's okay. So it only takes 3 minutes, and then we just wait. Do you want under 200, so it's 185.
I'm Meg Megan Noah, and I am the director at South Bay Community Services in Brockton, Massachusetts. Today, we have our clothesline project on display, and that clothesline project is created by survivors, domestic violence, sexual assault, incest, and lots of other types of abuse. We do it for a couple of reasons. We want to display it in the community to spread awareness about the crimes that are happening, and also we want our survivors to have a healing process through the trauma they experience. And one way we offer them is to put their story on a t-shirt, kind of airing out their dirty laundry a little bit.
Man, I am hungry. I gotta find a snack. Oh, wait a minute. There's some hard candy, that'll do. Ah! Ah!
My name is Linda Cahill. I work for Brockton Public Schools. I'm the nursing supervisor.
I'm only 5 feet, five and a half inches.
Hi, Megan Haley. I'm a UMass Extension dietetic intern from Framingham State University. Capsaicin is a chemical compound in peppers that gives it the hotness that you feel when you eat it or when you topically put it on your body. Pepper spray is completely made up of it, of capsaicin.
Hi, I'm Ashley Farah.
Ashley, what's in the suitcase?
I can't tell you that.
Okay, now press play.
Paolo, what do you have here today?
So today we're showing kids exactly what it's like to be distracted while driving. We basically have a course here that kids can try and drive a mock vehicle through. And what they do is they put on some goggles or try to send a text while they're trying to get through the maze.
199, 200. Health and Wellness Fair at Brockton High School was fantastic. I had a great time. I hope you did too.
This is not an editing mistake. Just, we wanted you to listen. Listen to the music of the cars going by. But that sound does not compare with the Brockton High School chorus. Their annual choral was held at the high school. And it was amazing. Let's check it out.
Thank you.
You can't see the sky with all the cloud cover, but you can dream. And we're about to focus on some women that dreamed big and succeeded. They overcame a lot of obstacles and they are true pioneers. The event was sponsored by the NAACP, the topic, the NASA Space Program, and the women that led the charge. Let's take a look.
My name is Pat Monteith. I'm actually one of the newest solar system ambassadors. I just got appointed officially in January and had to go through a couple months worth of training. I really am interested in the women of NASA because I wanted to be one of the women of NASA. Here's Kitty O'Brien Joyner, who was the first woman engineer. She was hired in 1939, so NASA was a little bit before its time, and she was the first woman to complete her degree in electrical engineering from the University of Virginia. She managed several supersonic wind tunnels, and if you know anything about space and rockets, you know that wind tunnels are very, very important.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
Okay. If you know the story of Hidden Figures, you know the story is all about Katherine Johnson and her being a mathematician.
I entered college, I was 15. I was going to be a math teacher because that was it. You could be a nurse or a teacher. He said, "You're very lucky. Langley has a post for black mathematicians. Just opened it up to women. They had a pool of women mathematicians. They just wanted somebody to do all the little stuff while they did the thinking. We were called computers, women computers. I had been there less than a week when this engineer came in and wanted two women computers. And Mrs. Vaughn sent me over to the flight branch, and we never went back."
Today, a new moon is in the sky, placed in orbit by a Russian rocket.
Oh, they felt terrible that here we sat, and the Russians had a vehicle riding around looking down on you. So we set out to send somebody up there and look down, too.
Ignition sequence start.
I felt most proud of the success of the Apollo mission. They were going to the moon. I computed the path that would get you there. You determined where you were on Earth when you started out and where the moon would be at a given time. We told them how fast they would be going, and the moon would be there by the time you got there.
Beautiful, just beautiful.
It was my job, and I did my job correctly and well.
Anybody know who the new women of NASA are?
Growing up, I always assumed I would go into space.
Faye Jamison will be making her first trip in space today.
I always knew I wanted to explore because it was so mysterious. Where did we come from? I think that's a big part of it. It was the Apollo era, and everybody was thrilled about space. But I remember being really, really irritated that there were no women astronauts. And I remember people trying to explain to me why there weren't. I didn't buy it. There are a lot of people who felt left out. They didn't see themselves, and so they didn't see the connection back to them. I love science fiction because it allows you to look at people and societies from a different perspective. Star Trek was one of our most hopeful fantasies. It had people from all around the world on the bridge of the ship. And it even had an alien. And it had a woman of color in a technical role, Nichelle Nichols, who played Lieutenant Uhura. It helped me to say, yes, this is something that's reasonable to think about. That perspective of belonging was what was important to me.
Coming down.
Well, there you have it, Brockton. Another One North Main in the books. Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed this episode as much as we enjoyed covering these events and meeting some great people. To learn more about Brockton Community Access, please visit our website at bcatv.org. If you want to take a look back at previous One North Main episodes, as well as government meetings and other public events, you can check out our YouTube page at youtube.com/thebrocktonchannels, all one word. For executive producer Mark Lindy and producer Aaron Tebow, I'm Jay Miller, and we will see you around town.